That's probably going to be the biggest problem, is when physicians start seeing these new laws being put into place, they're going to be concerned that Big Brother's watching them, and that, well, now I'm not going to prescribe these anymore, I'll leave it to somebody else to do that. I'm just not going to, because I don't want to take the chance that somebody's going to come down on me and say that I'm over-prescribing. Again, you know, we're going to have to figure out how to deal with that, and the biggest thing is education, and hopefully our federal agencies will take a look and try and find a balance and not be coming down too heavily on people. Again, there are legitimate pain management physicians out there that are using scheduled drugs, using narcotic analgesics in their regular practice. I think the biggest thing that'll be the flag again is the numbers. You know, if you're prescribing this medication taken four times a day and giving them, you know, 120 pills at a time, and then 2 weeks later you're giving it to them again, or you're finding they're getting it from multiple different places, and again, the prescription drug monitoring program is going to do a lot of that, keeping track, which of course some people will also feel that Big Brother's watching them. But I think once we get a handle on where the numbers are, and again, the definition of what is legitimate use, and educating people on what's legitimate, I think things will settle down.
Well, don't you think that Big Brother needs to watch?
Absolutely.
I mean, I think, you know, we have gotten to the point where clearly somebody needs to watch. I think that there are provisions to make sure that that's not public record, that it's held privately. But at least it gives us a way of tracking who's writing, who's taking, and who's filling these prescriptions. And that should go a long way, don't you agree, to starting to put the blame where it needs to be for the people who are running the pill mills as opposed to legitimate pain practitioners.
There's a lot of kids dying out there. I've had to die in my arms, and it's not a nice feeling. I have these young 19-year-old, 20-year-olds just die from overdosing on these pills. I mean, it's incredible what's really going on. Somebody better be watching, because we're destroying our own culture. They're worried about terrorists hitting us. There's a hidden terrorist right here. It's called addiction. And it's called these pain pills. That's creating people that are, it's a nightmare. And we deal with it all the time on a treatment center. And it's real sad to watch parents watch their kids and see them, they're dead, and have to go to funerals, and it's not fun.
Yeah, because the other victims here, not only are the people who inadvertently get hooked, but the families, because it's not just Johnny or Susie. It's all the people who love Johnny and Susie suffer as they watch Johnny and Susie slip away. And that's what they do. Mr. Ferdy, you say
something? Yeah. Also, you know, when we talk about Big Brother watching, I don't think it has to be bad policy. What's happening, we have 35 other states that have already enacted the prescription drug monitoring program. It's extremely effective in cutting down. What are the main things the prescription monitoring bill and program, what does it do? It allows physicians and healthcare workers to not only look at what a person has been prescribed, but also to really figure out if this person is in fact dying. And once they have that information that is specifically private and cannot be accessed by the general public, it allows them, I think, to answer your question, it gives them that comfort level to now know I can go forward and prescribe to this individual and feel comfortable that I'm not giving them more, and that this person's going to have a chance of overdosing and dying because they're getting pills from five other different physicians. In Florida, with our prescription drug monitoring bill that was actually signed into law by Governor Crist, we have to look at the history. This bill we've been trying to get in this state for years, and it was only in the last year, 2009, when we actually got this bill signed. And really the thing that's been holding it back thus far is funding. And just last week we got it funded. $575,000, because the prescription drug monitoring program is not to be paid by the taxpayers. It's being paid by grants and funders. Unfortunately, what's happening right now is last week also a bill was proposed, a House Bill 225, by Representative John Legg. And he's proposing this bill that is really a parallel to our current prescription drug monitoring bill. However, they're calling it the Prescription Drug Monitoring Bill Lite, because it really undermines and guts the Prescription Drug Monitoring Bill that's already signed into law. Ironically, he actually voted for the prescription drug monitoring bill. I don't know what's going on, but the end result of what's going to happen is that if in fact these two laws are going to be out there signed into law and existing at the same time, there's going to be confusion now as to who's going to fund what and why should we fund both. And the money's going to get tied up and we're not going to see our prescription drug monitoring bill get enacted in December of this year. Again, ironically, this bill is also supposed to be put into effect at the same day that the prescription drug monitoring bill is also being put.
So if you have an opinion, call your legislators.
Well, pharmaceutical companies are really making a score out of it. And also, they should be paid for this. Look what's going on. They know what's happening. They see, how many of you not know what's happening? Millions of pills are going out like wildfire. They're making billions of dollars, and nobody really knows what's going on. Baloney.